Hello guys, this is new smartphone for Verizon prepaid service. It is LG Optimus Zone 3. Because it's a Verizon phone, it obviously supports CDMA and it also supports 4G LTE. It's a budget smartphone which Verizon sells for $70 for their prepaid service. It's not a big phone, it fits comfortably in palm of the hand. Obviously, because it's a budget phone, it's all plastic. The back shell is plastic, it's kind of ribbed. So the phone has 4.5 inch display, which is not even HD. It's 480 by 854, but considering screen size, it gives pretty decent pixel density, 218 pixels per inch, so you can use it for reading. For example, that says Flipboard. And it's pretty comfortable. It accepts SIM card and it also accepts micro SDHC card for memory expansion. It uses 4-core Qualcomm Snapdragon 210 processor at 1.1 GHz, which is okay for a budget phone. It has 1.5 GB of internal memory of RAM, and it has 8 GB of internal storage, and it can be extended up to 32 GB with our SDHC card. And let's look what connectors are outside of the phone. So on the bottom is micro USB slot, and also on the bottom is a headphone 3.5 millimeter jack, which may not be very convenient for you. For example, if you're listening to your streaming music in a car and you put your phone in a cup holder, there is a volume rocker on the left side, there is a power switch on the right side, and the top side has no connectors. It does accept SDHC card, which you put inside, so there is a small notch over here, and you can peel it out just with your nail. And it opens like this. So you can see immediately it has removable battery, which some consider a good thing, but I really don't think it's an important factor because, you know, in 2 or 3 years when battery dies, you probably will throw the phone away. I mean, if you're environmentally conscious, you probably will try to replace it, but most people will throw the whole phone away anyway. That's a place for SIM card, and it's a micro SIM card, and that's a place for micro SDHC card. So you can see inside the phone, it's all mostly plastic, the shell is plastic, and I think if you're going to buy this phone, you need to invest in a case, some kind of bumper case, to make sure it doesn't break when it falls. This phone can record 720p video at 30 frames per second exactly, both front and rear camera. And the video itself is not very good. Front camera records video at about 4 to 5 megabits per second. And it looks like more stable. Or maybe it's because I just kept it on my arm's length. Okay, this is front-facing camera, which is good enough for selfies. When you move around, right now it's about 4 p.m. and the sun is setting. The rear-facing camera records the same 720p video at 30 frames per second, but at high bitrate, 12 megabits per second. But still, even, I mean, it's a healthy bitrate for this resolution, but the video doesn't look good. It looks barely standard definition. It doesn't look like high def at all. Besides recording video, this phone can obviously play YouTube videos. So, for example, this particular video I shot and uploaded in 1080p 60. But if we look at YouTube settings, it says that it can be played only at 480p. It can be played at 720p, 60, it cannot be played at 1080p 60, it can't be played at 60 frames per second, period. It can only be played at 480 frames per second, 480p at, I guess, maximum 30 frames per second. So it's not very performant phone. And of course, this phone has Wi-Fi and also Bluetooth, and you can use Bluetooth for playing your music wirelessly, for example, through a Sonos system or in a car.